considered and fellowship with the brothers.
我们就与弟兄们一同的交通考虑。
And the title and the messages came out of what was on my heart.
这个主题和信息就从我的心里面浮出来。
And through fellowship, what we feel would meet the need of the churches.
借着交通，我们就觉得会应付众教会的需要。
And there's something about fellowship that I feel we can all advance.
关于交通的一些内容，我们觉得可以再进步。
This matter of fellowship is very important.
这个交通的这件事非常非常的重要。
It is in the book of 1 John.
在约翰一书里面。
I'll read the verse to you that is the inspiration for this time.
我要把这节经节读给你，是这个特会来自的灵感。
This is on the top of your outline, 1 John chapter 1, verse 3.
这是在纲要的一开头，约翰一书一章三节。
What we have seen and heard, we proclaim to you also, so that you too may have fellowship with us. And indeed, our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ.
我们将所看见、所听见的传给你们，使你们与我们相交。我们乃是与父并他儿子耶稣基督相交的。
John wrote this epistle when he was a very elderly brother.
约翰写这个书信是在他非常年长的时候。
And the churches at that time were undergoing so many trials.
那个时候众教会正在经过许多的试炼。
There wasn't just one antichrist, there were many antichrists.
不是只有一个敌基督，有许多的敌基督。
Brothers were hating each other.
圣徒们彼此憎恨。
And there were deceivers in the churches.
教会中也有一些欺骗者。
And there was a lot of strife in the churches.
教会生活中有很多的争竞。
And there was confusion as to who Jesus Christ really was.
有许多的问题关于耶稣基督到底是谁。
And John looked at the whole situation.
约翰看到整个的情况。
And it's as if he said, what's the one thing that can help this whole situation?
那到底有没有一个什么东西可以来帮助整个情形？
And his answer is this word, fellowship.
他的答案就是这个字，交通。
And I would say, if you look at any saint, any brother, any sister, and any church, any group of Christians,
我会说，你如果看许多的圣徒们、弟兄姊妹、很多的教会，
and you would ask, what could help their problem?
你会问一个问题，什么能够帮助他们的情形？
What could get them to another level?
能够什么能够使他们更被提升？
The answer is in this one word, fellowship.
答案很简单，就在这一个字里面，交通。
When I consider the churches among us,
当我考虑我们中间的众教会，
some are encouraging.
有些非常的叫人得鼓励。
Some are,
有些
When I consider brothers and sisters,
当我考虑弟兄姊妹们。
I look at some individuals, and I'm so hopeful.
有看到一些个人，我觉得好有盼望。
I see a bright future.
我看到一个非常光明的未来。
And then I look at other brothers and sisters.
那我看到其他的弟兄姊妹。
I'll let you put yourself in which category.
到底你在哪一个情形里呢？
Do you know what we all need?
你知道我们都需要什么吗？
We need fellowship.
我们需要交通。
John says his fellowship is with the Father.
约翰说他的这个交通乃是与父的交通。
And with his Son.
与他儿子的交通。
And then John proclaims his experience.
然后约翰就说到他的这个经历。
With the purpose.That the saints would come into the fellowship of the apostles.
盼望圣徒们能够进到与使徒们的交通。
And you see, the whole fabric of the church is enhanced by this one word, fellowship.
你看到整个教会的这个织造啊，就借着这个交通而被提升。
So if you look at the first three points under the Roman numeral one,
在第一大点的下面三个点,
there are a few words that I want us to think about when we think about fellowship.
这有几个字我愿意大家一同来考虑，当我们说到交通这个字的时候。
When I say fellowship, it is both simple and profound.
当我说到交通的时候，它是简单却又是深层次的。
Fellowship is so simple that even the youngest brother or sister can experience fellowship.
交通是如此的简单，就是最年幼的弟兄姊妹也可以来有份。
And you don't have to know a lot to touch this experience of fellowship.
你不需要知道很多很多的事情，好叫你可以来碰着这个交通这件事。
And if I say, "How is your fellowship with God?" you somewhat know.
当我说到你与神的交通如何呢？你应该有一点知道。
It's an openness.
那是一个敞开。
A nearness.
非常的亲近。
A flow of life.
这样子生命的交流。
An enjoyment.
非常的享受。
It's so simple.
好简单哦。
But it's also really profound.
但是还是非常有深层次的。
And fellowship is for even the oldest Christians, even the ones that John the Apostle would call the fathers.
然而交通也是为那些最年长的，甚至使徒约翰来说，他们是父老们的这般圣徒们。
In fact, John writes his epistles. In his epistle, he addresses it to the fathers, the young men, and the young children.
当约翰写他的书信的时候，他说父老们、青年人、小孩子们。
If a young child has simple fellowship, they might just say, "I love the Lord."
小孩子们当他们有交通的时候，他也许就简单的说，我爱主。
If a father, one of the fathers, an older Christian, older brother, older sister has fellowship.
当父老们那些年长的那些最年长的弟兄姊妹在交通的时候，
they probably have a sense that it is something connecting them to the Father and the Son.
他们会觉得里面有一个东西叫他们与这位父与并与这位子连接在一起。
And that fellowship joins them with the purpose of the triune God that he's carrying out on the earth.
这样的交通叫他们与这位三一神在地上的经营连接在一起。
And a father has fellowship and it's so profound.
与这位父的交通是如此的深层次。
And then a child has fellowship and they just say, "I kind of love the Lord."
那个小孩子就说，我就是爱主。
It's the same fellowship.
却是同一个交通。
But it's on different levels.
却是有许多不同的层次。
And let me tell you, all of us can look at ourselves and say, we're pretty distant from the Lord.
我们每一位都可以看看自己说，我们与主何等的遥远。
If you're a younger believer, you might say, "I'm distant from the Lord because of TikTok."
也许你是一个年幼的圣徒，你会说我与主这么的遥远，因为 TikTok.
The Bible or TikTok?
圣经或是抖音.
And then you feel like, "Oh Lord, less TikTok, more Bible."
你就祷告主啊，少一点抖音，多一点圣经.
If you're an older believer,
也许你是位年长的圣徒,
you start to realize the barrier in here.
你就开始知道那个真正的障碍是在这里面。
The barrier in here.
那个障碍是在这里面。
And you might have a sense, "I can't change."
也许你有一个感觉，我不能改变。
Or you may not even know you can't change.
也许你也不知道你不能改变。
You're set.
你已经这个定型了。
You know what's right.
你知道什么是对的。
You know how to be.
你知道该作为什么。
You know how the church should be.
你知道教会应该怎么样?
And you're completely wrong and completely dead.
可是你却是如此的错误，如此的死神。
You're doing the same things that you did for so many years.
你每年每年同样做了同样的事。
You know what you need?
你知道你需要什么?
Fellowship.
你需要交通。
It's so simple.
好简单。
Yet it's so profound.
却是如此的深层次。
Part B is it is personal and corporate.
下一个点是，这交通是个人的，也是团体的。
It's something that everyone personally must experience.
这是一个每一个人个人都可以来经历的。
In the morning.
早晨。
At 6 a.m.
6点钟。
When you wake up.
当你起床的时候。
Or if you're a college student.
也许你是个大学生。
At 2 p.m. when you wake up.
下午2点你起床的时候。
You open the Bible.
你打开圣经。
And you just come to the Lord.
你就来到主的面前。
And you sense a flow of the divine life.
你就感觉到一个神圣生命的交流。
And your heart has a river of water flowing through it.
你的心里面就有一个生命的水流流过来。
You just love the presence of the Lord.
你就是享受主的同在。
Fellowship is personal.
交通是个人的。
But fellowship is also corporate.
但是交通也是团体的。
It's not just personal.
不只是个人的。
One time,
有一次,
somebody said, a sister said, I'm pregnant.
有一位姊妹说我怀孕了。
This is a personal matter.
这是一件个人的事。
It is a personal matter.
是的，是个人的事。
But soon people will see the baby.
很快的，人们就会看见这个婴孩。
So you can't hide it forever.
你不能一直把它藏起来。
I don't know if that was the best illustration.
我不知道这是不是最好的例子。
But fellowship is personal.
交通是个人的。
But it's also corporate.
但是也是团体的。
There's a sense that the whole church is being united together.
有一个感觉就是整个教会啊被连接在一起。
In fellowship.
在交通里。
It's not a uniformity.
不是一个一致性。
It's not a I listen to that guy.
不是说我听那个人。
It's not a I listen to the leaders.
不是说我听那些年长的。
It's organic.
它是生机的。
It's a fellowship that is all together.
那是一个全部在一起的交通。
It's a spiritual.
是属灵的。
It's that sister has fellowship with the Father and Son.
那是那一位姊妹有这样子与父与子的交通。
That brother has fellowship with the Father and Son.
那位弟兄有这样与父与子的交通。
And they're living together in a church life.
当他们在教会中生活在一起的时候。
And you see, there's fellowship between them.
你就看见他们彼此有交通。
And there's a sharing between them.
他们彼此有一些的分享。
And the whole thing is brought together.
整个就被带在一起了。
Under the flow of the triune God.
借着三一神的流露而在一起。
It's not organizational.
不是组织的。
Fellowship is something organic.
交通乃是生机的。
And in John's view,
约翰的这个看见,
it's grand.
好大呀!
The corporate aspect of fellowship is grand.
这团体的一面是何等的宽广啊!
Listen to his words. We proclaim to you that you may have fellowship with us.
他说呢, 我们与你们相交。
And our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son.
这交通乃是与父并与他儿子耶稣基督所有的。
So you have Father and Son.
父与子。
And then the apostles.
还有使徒们。
And then the saints.
还有圣徒们。
And then you realize the whole world, all the Christians, all the believers, they're all united into the same vision and same purpose as the Father and Son.
你就看见整个世界所有的圣徒基督徒们都在一起在这位父与子的这个旨意里面。
What's this from? Fellowship.
这是从哪里来的? 交通。
It's accessible.
是可取用的。
And ever deepening.
是可进入也是不断加深的。
You know, you can fellowship right now.
你现在就可以有交通。
When you're driving in your car,
当你在开车的时候,
you can fellowship.
你可以交通。
There was one sister
有一个姊妹,
who bought a waterproof book cover.
买了一个防水的这个包的这个皮身皮。
So she could put her Bible in the book cover and read it while she's taking a shower.
所以她可以把她的圣经放在这个防水的包这个皮里面，在她洗澡的时候可以读圣经。
Isn't that inspiring?
是不是很有灵感啊？
You're washing your hair. Reading John.
不需要翻译。
Fellowship is accessible.
交通是可进入的。
You can even fellowship with the Lord when you're in the shower.
你在洗澡的时候都可以与主交通啊。
Anywhere.
无论何处。
But it's also ever deepening.
但是又是不断加深的。
And you might have a sense like, I'm not deep enough yet.
也许感觉我现在不够深。
That is a good sense.
那是一个非常好的感觉。
I have some dictionary definitions of fellowship here.
有一些这个学者们的一些定义关于交通。
This is one dictionary. The Greek word is koinonia.
希腊字是 koinonia, 关于交通。
And it's an association involving close mutual relations and involvement.
是说一种有着彼此的亲密关系和参与关系的联系。
So from that definition,
借着这个定义,
you just have a sense that you're close.
你觉得很亲近。
You're just close with God.
你与神亲密了。
You can say simple phrases like this.
你可以说一些非常简单的片语。
I have God.
我有神。
I have God.
我有神。
He's just so close.
他好亲近哦。
When I'm taking an exam,
当我在考试的时候,
He might not give me the right answer.
他也许不会告诉我标准答案是什么。
But he'll be with me as I write the wrong one.
但是当我写那个错误的答案的时候，他仍然与我同在。
I just have God.
我有神。
When I'm arguing with somebody,
当我跟一些人争吵的时候,
I might lose my temper.
也许我发了脾气了。
But even then, I have God.
但是就是这个时候，我仍然有神。
I'm just close.
我与神这么的亲近。
And if I would ask him,
如果我问他,
God, Jesus, can I just have a break from you for just maybe half an hour?
神，我们能不能暂时断绝交通半个小时？
He might say, No, I can't do that.
他也许会说不可以，我没办法做得到。
I'll just be with you.
我还是与你同在。
Through the half an hour when you're taking a break from me.
当你半个小时不愿意与我在一起的，我仍然与你在一起。
I always like it when people say, I'm blaming God for not answering my prayers. God, you don't answer my prayers. You don't listen.
我总是觉得当人抱怨神说你不听我的祷告的时候，
I love it when people say that.
对于有人这样说的时候，我觉得很好。
Do you know why? Because they're still talking to God.
为什么？因为他们仍然在与神说话。
God, my problem with you is you don't listen to me.
神, 我对你的问题就是你不听我的祷告。
And then God might say, I hear you.
神会说我已经听见了。
And he would say, this is fellowship.
他就说这就是交通。
We're having fellowship.
我们有交通。
You're upset with me?
你觉得对我非常的生气。
And I'm listening to you?
我却听你。
What more do you want? This is fellowship.
你还要什么更多呢？这就是交通。
You just feel close.
你觉得很亲近。
It's just, you're just close.
好亲近啊。
But it's not just that.
但是不止这样。
Let's look at the next definition.
看到下一个定义。
A relation between individuals, listen to this, which involves a common interest and a mutual active participation in that interest and in each other.
他说一种涉及某种共同利益处的个体之间的关系，在此关系中各个体彼此主动有份于此益处，且个体间互相有份。
Fellowship involves a common interest.
这个交通有这个彼此之间共同的益处。
For this, we don't think about this too much.
我们并不想到这个。
We might think fellowship is just close.
我们也许想交通就是亲近。
And Christians have a lot of strange thoughts about what fellowship is.
基督徒们啊，有很多关于交通的奇怪想象。
Sometimes churches build buildings where they they can play basketball.
有时候有一些教会会这个盖一个他们可以打篮球的一个地方。
So the brothers can get together or sisters can get together and play basketball.
使得弟兄们姊妹们可以来在一起一起打篮球。
And they might call that building the fellowship hall.
也许他们就把那个地方叫做交通。
So brothers, get together.
弟兄们在一起。
And they're playing basketball.
打篮球。
And then they're like LeBron James.
说詹姆斯。
What is LeBron James in Chinese?
詹姆斯。
Oh, that is LeBron James. Okay. And then the brothers were like, we play basketball together.We have fellowship.
弟兄们就说我们在一起打篮球，我们有交通。
That's basketball fellowship.
这是篮球交通。
That's what some people think. Fellowship.
有些人这么想。
Then maybe sisters get together.
也许一些姊妹们来在一起。
And they get together.
他们再来在一起。
And they open up one another's hearts to each other.
他们彼此敞开。
And they cry.
他们就哭了。
And they would say, "Oh, we really have fellowship."
他就说我们好有交通哦。
I felt her pain.
我感受到她的痛苦。
Well, okay, that's very good.
非常好。
But fellowship is more than close.
但是交通不仅仅是亲近。
It's a common interest.
它是共同的利益。
And so I joke, there's fellowship and there's telloship.
我在开玩笑说有交通还有 telloship. 电话交通。
Sorry. Fellowship.Is when you can come to a common interest.
交通是你可以来到一种共同的益处。
Fellowship is just when you tell the other person what you're going to do.
Fellowship 只是彼此在那里说你彼此的事情。
I want to let you know that I am going this way.
我要告诉你我要这么走。
And I let you know that, so we have had fellowship.
我这样子告诉你，所以就表示我们有交通。
That wasn't fellowship. That was telloship.
那不是真正的交通，那是一种汇报。
And we do that with God all the time.
我们跟神有这样子，一直是这样子。
God, should I buy this car?
神，我应不应该买这辆车
？It's really nice.
太好了。
I asked him 15 times.
我已经问他十五次了。
And he said, in the 15th time, yes.
十五次他都说是的，可以。
I don't know if he said yes.
我不知道他到底是不是说可以。
Fellowship is not fellowship.
汇报不是交通。
Fellowship is when you drop your interest.
交通乃是你把你自己的益处放一边。
The other person drops their interest.
另外一个人也把他们的益处放一边。
And you come together for a common interest.
而你来到一起为着一个共同的益处。
I have my interest.
我有我的益处。
God, the Father, has his interest.
神父神有他的益处。
And eventually, because of our interaction, we come together for a common interest.
然后因着我们彼此的交通呢，产生了一个共同的益处。
It's not just close.
不只是亲近。
Although it's very close.
当然非常亲近。
But it's a common goal.
但是它是一个共同的目标。
And then there's an active participation in that interest.
还有一个主动的这个参与。
And you have a life together.
你们有一个共同的生活。
Okay, we will talk more about that.
我们待会会讲的更多。
But we want to get a picture of the Apostle John.
我们要得到使徒约翰的一幅图画。
And to see how he was prepared by the Lord.
看看他怎么样被主来预备。
For this ending of his ministry.
在他执事的结束的时候。
And for the end of his ministry, when he wrote his epistle.
当他在他执事的末了写书信的时候。
And in that epistle, he introduces this thought of fellowship.
在那个书信里面，他带进这个关于交通的事。
And I think that there's no way to say that that just came out of some theological understanding that John had.
那不是出于一些神学的认识，约翰所有的。
It came out of a definite experience and life with the Lord.
而是来自于在约翰里面与神那个明确的交通。
And if you look at the Apostle John's life, you'll see that he went through many unique experiences with the Lord.
当你看看约翰的一生，你知道他经过了许多与主特别的关系。
And these unique experiences prepared him.
这些独特的关系已经来预备他。
They shaped him.
使他成为今天的形式。
And they directed him.
也这样子带领他。
And they changed him.
也改变他。
So that eventually he could say, our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son.
所以最终他可以说，我们的交通乃是与父并与他儿子耶稣基督所有的。
So it starts off with your experience of the Lord Jesus.
所以这个交通来自于你跟主的经历。
And it starts off with John's experience of the Lord Jesus.
也来自于约翰自己与神的经历。
So in your outline, I've chosen and highlighted just a few experiences of John that highlight this.
所以我在我的纲要里面呢，提出了约翰所经历的一些事件。
And we'll look through these experiences, and then we'll see how they build on this whole picture of a man who is in fellowship with the Father and Son.
我们来看看这些事例，来好让我们了解这一个人怎么被神与父神与子神的这样的一个交通所构成。
So the first thing is we'd like to see how John was called by the Lord.
首先我们要看约翰怎么被呼召的。
And I'll read this Matthew 4:21-22.
我要读马太四章二十一、二十二节。
Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee.And John, his brother, in the boat with Zebedee, their father, mending their nets. And he called them. Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him.
从那里往前走，又看见弟兄二人，就是西比泰的儿子雅各和他兄弟约翰，同他们的父亲西比泰在床上补网。耶稣就招呼他们，他们就立刻舍了船，别了父亲，跟从了耶稣。
What the disciples were doing when they were called by the Lord is significant. When Peter was called by the Lord, he was throwing a net into the sea.
当彼得被主呼召的时候，他正在向海撒网。
So you could imagine Peter going like this.
你可以想象彼得这么撒网。
And while he was going like this, Jesus said, Peter!
当他这样做的时候，主耶稣说，彼得！
And then Jesus gave him a lesson.
然后耶稣就给他讲了一篇话。
You see that net that was going in there to catch fish?
你看到那个你撒到海里要捕鱼的那个网吗？
Well, you are going to be catching men alive.
彼得，你就要成为得人的渔夫。
That net was, you thought was for fish, but I'm going to make you a fisher of men.
那个网你以为在网鱼，我要叫你成为一个。
Maybe when Peter saw that, he thought, wow, my whole life is marked out by the Lord. If Peter were a stone carver, it wouldn't work so well. You would say, like, I'm going to take stones and chisel them away.
这个敲石头这样子来,
but God didn't make Peter a stone carver. He allowed him to be a fisherman. So that when he was casting the net into the sea,
所以当彼得向海里撒网的时候,
Jesus would say, I want you to do that.
我要你做这个。
And you see, his whole life was catching men in the gospel. Well, John had a unique experience also. He wasn't throwing his nets into the sea. He was on the shore mending them. When Jesus called him, he was mending a net. That's very significant. Let me give you an example.
Kevin.
So, this is somebody who their net is not mended. So, Kevin, you be the fish. Like the fish. Okay. And this net is not mended. Like that. Okay, come on over here. And then a fish comes by. This is a person without a net, without a mended net. And then a fish comes by, and the fish is something good. It's a blessing from the Lord. It's a person from the gospel. It is grace. It's all of the things that are that God has given. And then just swim. Unmended. Okay, the church is ready to go, and then we're ready to receive the Lord's blessing. Okay. John comes. You need fellowship. And I am just proclaiming fellowship. And then he starts to know Father and the Son. And he's in the fellowship of the apostles. And he starts to be fixed. The net is mended. So fish comes by. And then fish. Right there. Yeah. He got one!
我们终于捕到一条鱼了!
Thank you, you can sit down. So, you see, John's like, oh, I was fixing the nets.
约翰在那里捕网。
Jesus called me when I was doing that.
当耶稣呼召我的时候，我正在捕网。
And then, I see the holes in the church net.
哎呀,在
And I see the holes in so many saints. So many blessings of the Lord just go by. And you just miss 他就在那里, Why? Because no fellowship. John might say, you know what? I'm a mender.
约翰说,
I am a mender.
我是一个补王者。
How many in this room can say, I am a mender?
这个房间里面有哪些人可以说我是个补王者?
Oh, you don't have to create the blessing of the Lord.
你不需要创造神的祝福。
There's no problem
没有问题的。
With the blessing.
祝福是很多的。
Do you know what the problem is?
你知道问题是什么吗?
With the net.
因为网不对。
There's no problem
没有问题。
With the Lord pouring out His blessing.
主降下倒下他的祝福没有问题。
You know what the problem is?
你知道问题是什么吗?
There's a hole in the net.
在网上面有洞。
You might be inspired by a word from the Bible.
也许你为着圣经里面的一个话觉得受灵感。
Then you forget it.
但是你忘记了。
It just went.
它就这么跑掉了。
What happened?
为什么呢?
Hole in the net.
因为有一个洞。
There may be a move of the Lord in a coworker.
也许在某一个同工身上有一个主的工作。
Or a move of the Lord in another student.
也许在一个学生身上有一个主的工作。
And when you're there, you just you can't catch it.
你就没有办法抓住它。
No problem with the Lord's blessing.
主的祝福实在没有问题。
Net.
网。
It's a hole in the net.
在网上面有一个洞。
John was called for this.
约翰为此被呼召。
Well, when the Lord, he didn't start out that way. It was kind of like the Lord was telling him, it's a sign, like, this is your future ministry. But when the Lord first called him, it's very interesting how the Lord considered John. He didn't start off this way.
开始的时候，好像主并没有这样子开始约翰。
And when he was called, I'll read the verses. This is Mark 3:14-17.
我要读这个马可3:14-17节。
And he appointed 12.
他设立12个人。
So that they would be with him, and that he could send them out to preach, and to have authority to cast out demons. And he appointed the 12, Simon, to whom he gave the name Peter. And James, the son of Zebedee, and John, the brother of James. To them he gave the name Boanerges, which means sons of thunder.
要与自己同在也差他们去传道，并给他们权柄赶鬼。这十二人中有西门，耶稣又给他起名叫彼得，还有西比泰的儿子雅各和雅各的兄弟约翰，又给这两个人起名叫伯尼奇，就是雷子的意思。
Wow, you're faster than I am.
I'm just reading.
Oh, okay. So Peter, to Simon, he says, you're a stone.
对西门说，你是彼得，你就是一个石头。
And this is how John started off with Jesus.
约翰是这样子与主开始的。
He looked at John and his brother James.
他看到约翰和他的兄弟雅各。
And he might have shaken his head.
他就摇头了。
You're a son of thunder.
你们两个是雷子啊。
Maybe he would first see John.
也许他先看到约翰。
And hear.
好像,
A son of thunder.
雷子。
Maybe he was just like, let's go.
也许他是这样子, 走吧!
He was maybe pretty strong.
也许他很强。
Pretty emotional.
非常的情绪化。
He wanted what he wanted.
他就是要他所要的。
He was a fast runner.
他是一个很快的跑者。
We know from Gospel of John that he ran faster than Peter.
从约翰福音我们知道约翰跑得比彼得更快。
Even John said that in his old age.
约翰到了年老的时候还说我跑得比彼得快。
He said, by the way, I ran faster than Peter.
他说, 顺便提一提，我还是跑得比彼得快。
He's a son of thunder.
我是雷子。
In the race, you know, the disciples always used to argue, which one is greatest?
门徒们啊，总是在那里啊，彼此比较，说谁比较大。
And maybe John is like, I don't know if I'm more spiritual than you, but I can beat you in a race.
约翰对彼得说, 我不知道我是不是比你更属灵,但是跑步我一定赢你。
Somehow, he's just like, there's something there that's like, let's go.
里面有一个东西说, 走吧, 走吧。
And maybe something there like, I'm the best of the apostles.
也许里面有一个东西, 我是门徒们中最好的那一个。
So Jesus just looked at him.
耶稣说,
and he looks at him and says, like, ho, ho, this one might be challenging.
他看到这个雷子说, 哎呦, 这个很挑战哦。
But don't worry. If you're challenging, you can still be with Jesus.
但是不用担心, 不管你怎么挑战, 你还是可以跟耶稣在一起。
And he knows how to handle you.
他知道怎么来对待你。
He's been handling people for at least 2,000 years as Christians.
耶稣在2000年来不断地对待各样各种各样的人。
And he's handled people for many, many more years in the Old Testament.
而在旧约时代他也对待了许许多多的人。
So if you're a son of thunder, don't worry, just be with Jesus.
如果你是雷子,没有关系, 只要与耶稣在一起。
You don't have to become a son of a tulip
你不需要做,
and then be with Jesus.
你不需要成为郁金香之子才能够与耶稣同在。
You can still be a son of thunder.
你还是可以做一位雷子。
Just stay with Jesus.
只要与耶稣在一起。
And that's what John was.
约翰就是这样一位。
And so we'll look at three incidents.
我们看三件事。
When John was with Jesus.
当约翰与主同在的时候,
and you see somewhat of a son of thunder.
你确实看到一个雷子的情形。
There was a time when all of the apostles, the 12 apostles, they were arguing about who was greater.
这里有一个时候,当这些门徒总是争论谁为大。
I would have loved to have been in the room when they were doing that.
我好想在那个房间里面,当他们在彼此争论谁为大的时候。
Maybe Matthew was saying, I was so great.
也许马太会说, 我好,
did you see me cast out those demons?
我真棒啊, 我当我赶鬼的时候,
and then maybe Peter was saying, I did it with one finger.
彼得说, 我用一根手指头就干成了。
And maybe Bartholomew was saying, did you see when I taught that person?
也许巴多罗买会说, 你有没有看到当我教那个人的时候?
Oh, the anointing.
哇, 膏油就出来了。
After this argument,
争论完了以后,
John approaches Jesus and says this.
约翰就来到耶稣面前说这个话。
He says this, Master,
夫子,
we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow along with us.
我们看见一个人奉你的名管鬼,我们就禁止他,因为他不与我们一同跟从你。
That's very interesting.
很有意思。
First of all, I'm interested in this. Like, do you know that when Jesus was on in his ministry and he had his group of disciples, there were people that were not with them?
当耶稣尽职的时候,地上的执事的时候,他有一群门徒们,但是有人跟他不在一起。
Can you believe that?
你可以相信这话吗?
I thought Christians were divided today.
我觉得基督徒是今天才分裂的。
But even at that time, there were people that were not with Jesus.
但是事实上在那个时候就有人不与耶稣同在。
When Jesus was there.
当耶稣在那里的时候,
and they were casting out demons.
那些人也在赶鬼。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名赶鬼。
Can you believe that? There's something like that.
你能相信这样的事情吗?
I'm shocked.
我是震惊啊。
Well, I'm not shocked now that because I know how divisive Christians are.
如果今天来看, 我不会那么震惊, 因为今天的基督徒实在是有很多的分。
But I'm shocked that it started so early.
我觉得很震惊, 因为在主耶稣的时候就这样了。
Well, this is John's response.
这是约翰的回应。
Stop that!
不可以这样做!
So just imagine somebody casting out a demon in the Lord's name.
在主的名里。
And then the person whose demon was just cast out of them are like, thank you, Lord.
有一个人, 他身上有鬼正在被赶出去, 他在那里说, 感谢主。
And this is John. Stop.
约翰那说, 不可以。
Stop.
不可以。
Son of thunder.
我是雷子。
I'm going to make everyone like us.
我要每一个人都跟我一样,
I'm going to make everyone with us. And then I am going to report it to Jesus. So he can say, Good boy.
主耶稣能够说很好很好孩子。
Jesus just says this. You know what? Don't hinder him.
耶稣说不要禁止他。
John, just don't hinder him.
约翰不要禁止他。
If he's not against us, he's for us.
因为不抵挡你们的就是帮助你们的。
John, can you be a little bit broader?
约翰啊，你能不能更宽广一点？
Can you be a little bit more inclusive?
你能不能更包容一点？
You know, sometimes Christians say, "We're it."
啊，有时候基督徒会说，这就是了。
We're it, and there's no move of God apart from us.
啊，会说我们就达到了，在我们之外没有任何神的工作。
Well, we do have a commitment from the Lord.
我们确实有从神来的托付。
And that commitment, we should hold that commitment before the Lord.
我们在神面前要持守那个托付。
That's really important because if you don't hold your commitment before the Lord, then how can the Lord work with you?
因为你如果不能这样持守主所给你的托付，神怎么能够在你身上有工作呢？
But holding that commitment from the Lord should not include a despising of what the Lord would do in a broad sense.
但是持守主的托付并不包括轻视主在其他地方所做的事。
We try to prevent him because he does not follow along with us.
我们试着要禁止他，因为他不与我们一同跟从你。
And the Lord just says, "Don't hinder him."
耶稣说不要禁止他。
John, just follow me.
约翰，跟从我。
John, let's just continue together.
让我们继续一同行走。
John was a worker.
约翰是一个工人。
A Christian worker.
一个基督徒工人。
And Jesus was training him.
耶稣却在这里训练他。
Don't hinder him.
不要禁止他。
Just follow me.
只要跟从我。
Just follow me.
只要跟从我。
Well, just a few verses later.
待会有一些经节。
Jesus was aiming to go into Jerusalem.
耶稣要准备往耶路撒冷前行。
This was maybe about 1 year before he is crucified.
也差不多他钉十字架之前一年。
And he's in the northern Galilee, in the Galilee region.
他在北边加利利区。
And then they had to go through Samaria to get down to Jerusalem.
他们需要经过撒玛利亚，好往南走到耶路撒冷。
And so the disciples went in front of Jesus.
门徒在耶稣前面走。
And prepared the way for him.
为他预备道路。
So they went into different villages and prepared the way for them to travel there.
所以他们去到不同的村庄，在那里预备。
And then one of the villages of Samaria said, "No, we do not welcome him."
有一个村庄在撒玛利亚说我们不欢迎他。
And the reason that they didn't want to welcome him is because Jesus was going to Jerusalem.
他们不欢迎他的原因是因为耶稣要到耶路撒冷去。
And there was some problem between the Samaritans and the Jews in Jerusalem.
在撒玛利亚人跟犹太人中间，在耶路撒冷有一些的问题。
So James and John respond to this.
约翰跟雅各这么回应。
And they saw this.
他们看见这个。
And they said to the Lord,
他们告诉主,
Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them?
主啊，你要我们吩咐火从天上降下来烧灭他们。
What a funny statement.
如何如此的雷子。
Okay, the funny thing about this is, I wonder what they would have done if Jesus had said yes.
我很好奇，如果主耶稣说好。
Did you ever think about that?
你想过吗?
Then James and John would have to say, like, we've never really commanded fire. How do we do that?
也许约翰跟这个雅各就会想，哎，我们从来没有叫吩咐火从天上降下来过，我们到底怎么做？
Maybe they would say, I started a campfire once.
也许他会说，我曾经生过那个在露营营地里面生过火。
But then the other would say, No, that was with a match. That was with a match. That wasn't fire from heaven.
不不不，那是用火柴点燃的，不是天上降火下来的。
I don't know if they really thought through this statement.
也许他们没有想过，他们到底为什么说这句话。
Lord, do you want us to command fire?
主啊，你要不要我们从天上吩咐火降下来？
Jesus just saw like, huh, that's a sign of thunder.
耶稣看见他们就说，哇，这就是雷子。
Yeah, does he love me? Yes.
他爱我吗？是的。
Does he have issues? Yes.
他有问题吗？是的。
So he just looks at them.
他看见他们,
and he rebukes them. It's a rebuke.
这是一个责备。
And then he says this, and these next words are not included in every manuscript, but many of the Bibles do include it, and some manuscripts do include it.
这个话并没有在每一个抄本里面有，但是有一些有。
You do not know what kind of spirit you are of.
你们的灵如何，你们并不知道。
Son of man did not come to destroy men's lives, but to save them.
人子来不是要灭人的性命，是要救人的性命。
Let's just go to another village.
我们到别的村中去吧。
Isn't the Lord so good?
哇，主真好。
He was saying, you know, as a servant of the Lord, you have to know what kind of spirit you are.
作为主的仆人，你必须要知道你的灵如何。
Maybe they were very inspired and said, we have the spirit of Elijah.
也许他们非常的受感动，说我们有以利亚的灵。
And Elijah called fire down.
以利亚叫火从天上降下来。
And we are very much for the Lord, and we want to call fire down. We have the spirit of Elijah.
我们这么样为着主，我们要叫火从天上降下来，我们像以利亚一样。
And maybe the Lord was pointing, no, you're not Elijah, you're Elisha.
也许主对他们说，你不是以利亚，你要像以利沙。
That's a real difference.
非常的不同。
Your spirit.
你的灵。
You know what kind of spirit you have.
你知不知道你有怎样的灵？
It's not a spirit of a harsh judgment.
不是一个这个强烈的一个责备。
It's not a spirit of fire coming down.
不是叫火从天上降下来的灵。
No, it's a spirit of this. Let's just go to another village.
不，乃是一个我们到别的村庄去的灵。
Let's let them be.
我们就让他们这样吧。
And let's let the Lord work.
让主有时间工作。
This is a kind of spirit.
这是那样的灵。
John, Son of Thunder, was really learning.
约翰，这位雷子，的确学了功课。
It's interesting that in Acts chapter 8, John goes back to Samaria.
很有意思，在《使徒行传》第八章，约翰回到撒玛利亚。
And I like to think he might have seen the same people.
我会想他可能见到同一班人。
When he goes back to Samaria, what happened was Philip went to Samaria and preached the gospel to them.
当他去到撒玛利亚的时候，是腓力传福音者到了那里去。
And then Peter and John go and lay their hands on them that they might and pray that they might receive the Spirit.
彼得和约翰去到那里就听见这样的事情，就按手在他们身上，叫他们能够受圣灵。
Isn't that a beautiful irony?
是不是这样子非常美妙的图画？
Maybe some of those Samaritans were like, oh no, John's coming.
也许有一些撒玛利亚人说，哦不，那个约翰来了。
He was the one who asked the Lord, should we call down fire on them?
他是请主吩咐主，要主吩咐他们从让火从天上降下来的那一位。
Maybe some of the Samaritans would have thought, hey, he wanted to kill my mom.
也许有一些撒玛利亚人说，你想要杀死这个杀死我的母亲。
But then the Lord says, you don't know what kind of spirit you are.
但是主说，不不不，你不知道你的灵如何。
And you know what? Some years later,
几年后，
he comes.
他再回来。
And they receive the Spirit.
他们受圣灵。
They don't receive fire.
他们没有接受火。
They receive the Spirit.
他们却接受了圣灵。
Oh, we have to see. We might have enemies.
我们也许有仇敌。
And when we have enemies, we might think like, oh, I want to see fire come down.
我们也许有一些敌人，我们想要看见火从天上降下来。
How about this? Go to another village.
如何呢? 我们去到另外一个村庄。
Realize what kind of spirit you have.
要知道你有怎样的灵。
And that the Lord is able to work.
主能够在你身上有工作。
Let me tell you a personal testimony over the last, say, eight months or 1 year.
我要告诉你一个我个人的经历在已过的八个月到一年。
I have just seen so many different kinds of people come to know the Lord.
我看见好多不同的人来到认识主。
And my faith has been really strengthened.
我的信仰这样的被加强。
See people from all kinds of different backgrounds.
看见从各种不同的背景来的人。
See people from all kinds of different mindsets.
有不同的心态的人。
All kinds of different races.
有不同的种族的人。
And I would look at them and say, like, there's no way that they could receive the Holy Spirit.
之前我会看到说这样的人不可能接受圣灵的。And
it's very easy to think like, oh, just let fire come down.
很容易我就说啊，让火从天上降下来吧。They
don't receive us. No, we'll let fire come down.
他们不接受我们，让火下来吧。But
you don't know the work of the Lord.
但是你不知道主的工作。Oh,
I have learned and I have seen the work of the Lord.
我学到了，我也看见主的工作。The
hardest heart. The hardest heart can be touched by the Lord.
最硬的心可以被主来碰着。
The one who might say, there's no way that you could come into my village eventually comes to receive the Spirit.
哦，那些不让主进到他们村庄的人，最终可以接受大灵。
What was this? This was John's training.
那是什么呢? 这就是约翰所得着的训练。
Well, it doesn't stop there.
没有停在这里。
John and James, in this next section,
约翰跟雅各在下一段,
they came up to Jesus. This is Mark 10:35. James and John, the two sons of Zebedee, came up to Jesus saying, Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you. And he said to them, What do you want me to do for you? They said to him, Grant that we may sit one on your right and one on your left in your glory.
这是马可十章三十五节，西比泰的儿子雅各约翰近前来对耶稣说：“夫子，我们不论求你什么，愿你给我们做。”耶稣说：“要我给你们做什么？”他们说：“赐我们在你的荣耀里，一个坐在你右边，一个坐在你左边。”But
Jesus said to them, "You don't know what you're asking.
耶稣说,
Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or to be baptized with the baptism with which I am baptized?" They said to him, "We are able." And Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you shall drink." And you shall be baptized with the baptism with which I am baptized.
耶稣说：“你们不知道所求的是什么，我所喝的杯你们能喝吗？我所受的洗你们能受吗？”他们说：“我们能。”耶稣说：“我所喝的杯你们也要喝，我所受的洗你们也要受。”You
know, they just wanted to be something.
他们就是想要做一些。And
so they came to the Lord.
他们来到主面前。And
they asked him, "Could we be special?"
他问主：“我们能不能做特别一点啊？”
I don't know what the other disciples were indignant.
其他的门徒们一定是非常恼怒。
Maybe they were thinking of Peter.
也许我们看看彼得。
He's pretty good.
他很好。
He's pretty. Jesus likes him.
耶稣喜欢他。
But we want to muscle him out.
我们想要把他赶出去。
Jesus, right and left.
耶稣，我们两个一个左一个右。
James, Jesus, John.
雅各，耶稣，约翰。
Yeah. If you read the other gospels, they got their mom to come.
另外一本福音书，他们把他们的妈妈带进来了。Hey,
if you ask your mom to ask Jesus, that's pretty serious.
如果你把你妈妈找来跟耶稣说一些话，蛮严重的。
They just wanted to be something.
他们就是想要做一些事。
And Jesus eventually says, that's not mine to give.
耶稣说, 这不是我所可以给的。
That's really not mine to give.
耶稣最后说,
but what I can give you is this.
我可以给你的是,
I'll give you a cup.
我给你一个杯,
and I'll allow you to be baptized.
我也要叫你受洗, 受这个洗。
And they say, we're able.
他们说我们能。
I think they really learned. After this, John is a different person. And he just learned that it's not about like my position. It's not about my position in glory beside Jesus. It's not even about what the other saints view me as.
也不是其他的圣徒们怎么看我。
It's not about my position in the church.
不是因为我在教会里的地位。
It's not about my exaltation and glory.
不是我被如何被高举，如何有荣耀。
That is not the thing that brings real authority.
这不是带进真正的权柄的。That
is not the thing that gives life.
这也不是带进生命的事。
The only thing that gives life and the only thing that the Lord will give me is a cup.
只有这个杯能够给我生命，给我主所要的。
It's not what I can be.
不是我要做什么。
It's how much can I die.
是我能怎么样的死。
It's not my position.
不是我的地位。
It's how much I can be baptized.
而是我如何能够受怎样的洗。
And it's not how much the Lord gives me.
不是主所给我的。
But it's how much suffering I go through as I follow him.
而是我能够在跟随他的过程中受了多少的苦。
And that's the key.
那是真正的钥匙。
You don't need a platform for speaking.
你不需要一个大的讲台来讲道。
You just need to die.
你就需要死。
You don't need saints to exalt you.
你不需要圣徒们高举你。
John and James, you just need to die.
约翰彼得啊, 约翰雅各啊, 你们就需要死。
It's a different set of rules.
这不是那样的一种规则。
It's a different kind of life.
这是一个另外的生命。
I'm bringing you into fellowship.
我们把你带进交通。
And what is that fellowship? It's not about a throne. It's about a baptism and about a cup.
什么是那个交通呢? 不是宝座, 而是洗和那个杯。
And in the future, James was the first apostle to die.
未来的时候, 雅各是第一个殉道的人。
It was a one swipe, just cut off his head.
就有一个这样子的刀下来就砍斩了雅各的头。
And he was the first apostle to die.
他是使徒中第一个殉道的。
And sometimes in our life, there are quick sufferings.
有的时候在我们的人生里有一些的苦难。
You could call them acute.
也许你可以说是一个这个
things that happen quickly.
他说很快就发生了。
All of a sudden, there's a cut in your life.
突然间在你的人生里面有一个切割。
And John had the opposite experience.
而约翰却有一个不同的经历。
He had a long life.
他有一个很长的人生。
Facing so many different trials. You could call it the chronic baptism. The chronic cup. It's a cup every day. There's a bearing of that cross. And your life is full of both. Sometimes we say we want to be beside the Lord on the throne.
也许我们说,
the Lord says this, I want to give you acute and chronic baptism.
主说, 我要给你快的, 也要给你慢的进。
The Lord says, I want to give you acute and chronic cup.
我要给你一个急促的, 也要给你一个慢性的杯。
All the other things are for the Father to decide.
其他的事都是父来决定。
But what you can be willing for is I take that cup.
你只能说我愿意接受这个杯。
Lord, I'm willing to be baptized with the baptism.
主啊, 我愿意这样子来受洗。
And you may say like, oh, when I pray that, I'm not sure if I really can.
你也许说当我这样祷告的时候我并不确定我到底能不能这样做。
So I won't be so bold to do it.
我不能那么大胆地说。
To just pray it.
我就是祷告。
But John and James said they could.
但是约翰雅各说我们可以。
And you know what? They did.
你知道吗？他们确实经历了。
They were able.
他们是的。
It's not a small thing.
不是一件小事。
Tell the Lord.
告诉主。
I'm able to drink it.
我可以喝。
I'm able.
我可以。
That's what the Lord can give.
那是主所能给的。
It's like John.
好像是这样，约翰。
Through these three incidents.
经过这三个事例。
Was just a Christian worker.
他是一个基督徒工人。
And he wanted everyone to be with him.
他想要每一个人都跟他在一起。
He wanted power.
他想要这样子的能力。
He wanted position.
他想要一个地位。
He wanted results.
他想要一个结果。
And his interaction with the Lord just cut all that away.
他与主的这个交流说，哎呀，就是不要那些。
Let me tell you, what kind of spirit do you have?
主告诉他，你有什么样的灵？
Just let them alone. You follow me.
就不要理他们啊！ 你来跟从我。
What kind of spirit do you have？
啊， 你有怎样的灵？
He says, let's just go to another village.
There'll be a way
for the Lord, for the Spirit to come to the Samaritans eventually.
至终那灵会降下，降到这些撒玛利亚人的身上。
It's not about your position.
不是你的地位。
It's just about your cup.
是你所喝的杯。
About your baptism.
你所要受的浸。
And when you look at John's life, it's like he learned those lessons.
当你看看约翰的一生，你会觉得他学了那些功课。
How much barrier to fellowship these three things are?
他如何在这个过程中有这样子在那忍受的里面有交通？
It's a barrier to closeness with the Lord.
他这个他跟随主的障碍拿掉了。
It's a barrier to coming into a common interest with him.
在与进到与主这个共同利益的这个障碍。
John would say, "I'm interested in the throne beside you."
约翰说，我对你旁边的那个宝座有兴趣。
Jesus would say, "I'm interested in drinking the cup."
耶稣却说，我对于你要喝的杯有兴趣。
John would say, "I'm interested in everyone being with us."
约翰说。我对于每一个人都跟我们在一起有兴趣。
Jesus said, "I'm interested in you following me."
耶稣却说，我对于你跟随我有兴趣。
John would say, "I'm interested in power."
约翰说，我对能力有兴趣。
Jesus would say, "I'm interested in the Spirit eventually coming to gain them."
我对于那个至终能够降下在他们身上得着他们的那个灵有兴趣。
Maybe after this, John just was more open.
也许在这些事例以后，约翰就更敞开了。
And he becomes tender.
他就变成很柔细。
And even at the last supper,
在最后的晚餐
，it's almost like a different John.
好像已经是完全不一样的约翰了。
Jesus,
约翰，主耶稣
told people he was one of them.Will betray him.
耶稣说有一个人要出卖我了。
And John 13, it says this: Jesus became troubled in his spirit.
约翰十三章那里说耶稣心里忧愁。
Can you believe Jesus troubled?
你能不能相信耶稣心里忧愁
？Of course, Jesus is troubled in his spirit.
是的，耶稣心里忧愁。
And said, "Truly, I say to you." One of you will betray me.
我实实在在的告诉你们，你们中间有一个人要卖我了。
And then imagine that scene where the disciples were just looking at one another. It's like, is it you? Is it you? Is it you? Is it you?
想象那个场景，那门徒们彼此对看，是你吗？是你吗
？And you could imagine the complicatedness.
你可以想象那个中间的复杂。
Just think about in this room.
想想看, 在这个房间里,
if I would say one of you is going to burn this building down at 1 p.m.
如果我说, 在我们中间有一个人, 下午1点要把这个房子给烧掉,
we would all look.
我们就看来看去,
you? You?
是你吗?
Hmm?
你吗?
And John,
约翰, oh,
Kevin and Josh, come here. You be Jesus.
这是耶稣.
And in that troubled setting,
在一个非常忧愁的状况,
John was just leaning on his 约翰 bosom.
就靠在耶稣的身上.
Yeah. You know what a son of thunder would do? Let me find him.
雷子应该做什么?
Who's going to do it?
我要找出来,
I'll take care of it. And then I'll tell Jesus how great it was.
那,
I'll call fire down on them.
我要来解决这件事情,
but you don't see any of that.
但是他没有说,
you see this?
他看见吗?
Just there.
好像这样,
fellowship.
有交通,
this fellowship.
有交通.
He's troubled.
耶稣心里忧愁.
Jesus is troubled.
耶稣心里忧愁.
You don't try to solve it. You just fellowship.
你不要想着去解决它, 就是交通.
It's like he's learned.
好像他学了.
He's different, thank you.
不一样了.
That is very interesting. There was reclining on Jesus' bosom, one of his disciples whom Jesus loved. So Peter gestured to him and said to him, tell us who it is of whom he is speaking. So,
西门彼得点头对他说, 你告诉我们主是指的谁说的?
Isn't that interesting? So John's there like this. And then Peter doesn't ask Jesus.
你能不能想象, 约翰是这样靠着主, 但彼得没有自己问主,
he asked John.
他问约翰,
maybe he did sign language.
也许他用手语,
because Jesus is right there.
因为耶稣就在旁边,
I don't know why.
不知道为什么,
ask John, tell us who it is of whom he is speaking.
你告诉主是指的谁说的?
And then John, leaning back on Jesus like this,
那门徒就 就是靠着耶稣的胸膛问他说,
Lord, who is it?
主啊, 是谁呢?
Jesus then answered, the one for whom I shall dip the morsel and give it. So when he dipped the morsel, he took it and gave it to Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot.
耶稣回答说, 我蘸一点饼给谁, 就是谁? 耶稣就蘸了一点饼, 递给加略人, 西门的儿子犹大。
They still didn't get it.
他们还是不知道。
You would ask like, well, then they should have known it was Judas.
到说他们应该知道就是犹大。
But they still didn't know.
但是他们好像还是不知道。
Welcome to fellowship.
欢迎来到交通。
Lord, who is it? It's
主啊,
the one I dip the morsel in. So he dips it in. He says what he's going to do. And then he does it. And they don't get it.
我蘸了一点饼给谁，那就是他了。结果他给他了，但是他们还是没有得到。
But you know what John is? This. He loves me.
但是约翰在那里说他爱我。
He just loves me.
他爱我。
It's a disciple who Jesus loved, right?
他是耶稣所爱的那门徒。
He just loves me.
他就是爱我。
And I'm just lying on Jesus' bosom.
我就是躺在耶稣的胸膛上。
Is the problem solved? No.
问题有解决吗? 没有.
Is Jesus still troubled? Yeah.
耶稣还是忧愁吗? 还是的.
But it's a picture.
却有这个图画.
Fellowship.
交通.
It's fellowship.
交通.
Don't be a worker.
不要做一个工人.
You're not here to accomplish something.
你不是来在这里要想要成就什么事?
People, Christians that want to accomplish something, they're They're disappointed.
所有想要做工完成一些事情的基督徒们，他们都会失望。
They have goals that they're frustrated because they're not met.
他们都会自动都会失望。
And they're pretty far from fellowship.
他们与交通非常的遥远。
And you saw John when he wanted to call fire, when he stopped those people, when he wanted a position, no rest.
你看到那个约翰想要叫火这个降下来，想要叫这个禁止他们那个约翰，他没有安息。
But here, it's just Jesus loves me.
但是这里他却说耶稣爱我。
I love to be on the bosom of Jesus.
我愿意在耶稣的胸膛上靠着。
And I'm just there.
我就是在那里。
And the situation may not be different.
这个情形也许没有改变。
But you know what? I just have the presence of the Lord.
你却知道，我就是有主的同在。
And I'm just enjoying that He loves me.
我这么享受他爱我。
And I'm lying there.
我就喜欢在那里。
Fellowship.
这就是交通。
You know, all the disciples scattered.
所有的这些门徒们在一起。
When Jesus was, arrested, the trial and the cross.
当耶稣被逮捕，然后有许多的试炼，然后这个十字架。
And there's even a verse it said in Zechariah which says, "Strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered."
撒迦利亚有一节圣经说。
And Jesus quotes this verse when he talks to the disciples, to the apostles.
耶稣就提到这些圣经，当他跟那些门徒们说话的时候。
And he even says, "You will all leave me alone."
他说，你们都要离开我而去。
But I'm not alone because the Father is with me.
但是我并不是单独的，因为父与我同在。
But there's one mystery about John's life.
却是有一个奥秘在那里。
John was there at the cross.
只有约翰在十字架那里。
So I've studied quite a bit. When did John get scattered?
我真的很认真地研读到底约翰什么时候跑。
Oh no, you could study that too. When did John get scattered?
你也可以这样去研读到底约翰跑哪里的。
Because Jesus says, "You'll all leave me."
耶稣说你们都会离开我。
And we know when Peter left.
我们知道彼得走了。
After he denied the Lord looked at him and he went out.
他三次否认主的，主看了他，他就走了。And
he missed the whole crucifixion.
他就没有看见整个钉十字架的过程。Peter
missed the entire crucifixion.
彼得没有看见整个钉十字架。But
John was there.
但是约翰在那里。And
so I'll ask the Lord.
我要问主。When
was the verse in Zechariah fulfilled?
撒迦利亚那节圣经怎么得到应验呢？
So maybe one theory is when Jesus got arrested for like 5 minutes, John was like, "I'm out of here."
也许那个有一个理论是说，当耶稣被捕的时候，有那么五分钟，
And at that very time, all those verses were fulfilled. Like you're all scattered, and the Father's with me.
所以那节经节就得应验了，你们都。 被打散了，只有父与我同在。
But that's just my own speculation. I don't know.
这只是我的猜测，我不知道。
But John was there with the Lord.
约翰在那里与主同在。
And the Lord on the cross told John, "Your mom, my mom is your mom."
主耶稣在十字架上告诉约翰，我的母亲就是你的母亲。
And he told Mary, "John is your son."
他也告诉玛利亚，约翰是你的儿子。And
so John was there when none of the other apostles were there.
所以约翰在那里的时候，没有其他的门徒在。There
was a real closeness.
实在有一种亲近。And
John is the only one who saw this very special act.
约翰是独一一个看见这个特殊情形的人。After
Jesus had died.
耶稣死了以后。
This is in John 19:34.
这是约翰福音十九章三十四节。
One of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear.
我有一个兵拿枪扎他的肋旁。
And immediately, blood and water came out.
随即有血和水流出来。
And then, Look at the next verse.
下一节.
He who has seen has testified.
看见这事的那人就做见证.
His testimony is true.
他的见证也是真的.
He knows that he is telling the truth.
并且他知道自己所说的是真的.
So that you also may believe.
叫你们也可以信.
Why that verse?
为什么有这一节圣经呢?
It's like John was there.
约翰好像是在那里,
really close with the Lord.
与主那么近,
so that he could tell us,
他可以告诉我们,
I saw the soldier pierce his side.
我看见那个兵丁用枪扎他的肋旁,
and there was a flow out of that.
有东西流出来,
blood and water.
血和水.
You know why I am so close to the Lord? You know why I'm there, and maybe even like why I'm not fulfilling the verse in Zechariah? I need to see it. It's what I saw. And I'm testifying it. And I'm telling you about it. So that you may believe. And this is the message. Out of Jesus' side came blood and water. It's so important. How did I see it? Because I was there. Where are the other apostles? They're gone. Each one had their own issues, had their own problems, whatever. But I was with Jesus. I was with him while he was dying on the cross. And I have a very important message for you. Don't think Jesus is just a theological redeemer. Out of his side came blood and water. That's for you. That's a message for the world. And how did I see it? I only saw it because I was with Jesus. I'm in fellowship with him. I'm there while he's dying on the cross. After his death, I saw the soldier pierce his side. And two precious elements came out of Jesus. Let me tell you, there's a flow. The blood cleanses all of your sins. It was flowing out of Jesus' side. The water is a life-giving water. You can get life from him. You get a flow of life from him, a flow of divine life. Let me tell you, this is my testimony. This is what Jesus is. This is what he has done. How do I know that? Because I was there. What is the value of fellowship? You are there. You're there with Jesus. You're with him. And you see the blood and water flowing out of his side. Why are there problems in the churches? Because the brothers aren't there. They're not there. Maybe they want a throne. Maybe they want to call fire down. But where are the saints who are there? So John could say, he who has seen has testified.
他说,
and his testimony is true. And he knows that he is telling the truth. So that you also may believe. John could have written this in far fewer words. He could have just said, I saw it. He doesn't even need to include the verse. But he would just say, no, I was there. And you know what's so important? There was blood and water flowing out of his side. Oh, I've seen it. I testify it. And what I say is true. What a difference it makes when someone when a group of brothers, when a group of saints, a group of sisters is in fellowship with the Lord.
Oh, 如果有一群弟兄姊妹能够与主有这样的交通，会带来何等大的改变！
And you start to see, yeah, there's a solution in Him.
这里有一个解答。
There's a water flowing out. It's in Him.
水流出来了，在他里面。
And there's a power in the death of Christ. It's in Him.
哦，在那个耶稣的死里面有一种的能力在他里面。
Brothers, I see this. That you may, I testify that you may believe.
弟兄们，我看见这个，我愿意你们都相信。
What a different John.
这是一个何等不同的约翰。
What a different John.
不同的约翰。
It's different from, can I sit on your right side?
跟那个我要能不能坐在你左边右边呢？
What's better? The Lord told me to sit on your right side. That I would sit on His right side.
哪一个更好呢？ 如果他说，主啊，我可不可以坐在你的右边？主耶稣说可以。
Or this, out of His side flowed blood and water.
还是这个，从他的肋旁流出血和水来。
Oh, this is a life in fellowship with the Lord.
这就是在生命中与主交通的情形。
This was John's long life.
这是约翰长的一生。
And Jesus wanted him to have a long life.
耶稣愿意他有一个长的一生。
You know, it's not easy to follow the Lord over a long period of time.
要跟随主很长的时间不简单。
Sometimes,
有的时候,
people live in another country where it's harder to follow the Lord. Outwardly.
外面来看，有一些人在一些国家好像更难来跟随主。Maybe
they don't have as many material things.
也许他们没有一些物质上的东西。And
then they move to America.
然后他们搬来美国。And
things are so easy.
美国好简单啊。But
then they stop following the Lord.
但是他们就停止跟随主了。It's
too easy.
太容易了。Life
is too easy.
生活太容易了。And
you're in a setting where you're challenged.
但是你到一个情形里面要被挑战的时候
And it's not a fast challenge
不是一个快的挑战
It's a challenge of a long race
而是一个长的这个竞赛
And that is the gospel, that is the apostle John
那就是使徒约翰
Jesus told Peter how he was going to die
耶稣告诉彼得说他将要怎样死
Peter, turning around, this is John 21, verse 20, turning around, saw the disciple whom Jesus loved following them, the one who also had leaned back on his bosom at the supper and said, Lord, who is the one who betrays you? So Peter, go ahead.
这是约翰福音21章20节,彼得转过来,看见耶稣所爱的那门徒跟着,就是在晚饭的时候靠着耶稣胸膛说,主啊,卖你的是谁的那门徒?
So Peter, seeing him, said to Jesus, Lord, and what about this man?
彼得看见他就问耶稣说：“主啊，这人将来如何？”
What about John?
约翰将来如何？
Jesus said, "If I want him to remain until I come, what is that to you?"
耶稣对他说：“我若要他等到我来的时候，与你何干？”
You follow me.
你跟从我吧。
Therefore, the saying went out among the brethren that the disciple would not die. Yet Jesus didn't say to him that he would not die, but only, "If I want him to remain until I come." What is that to you?
于是这话传在弟兄中间，说那门徒不死。其实耶稣不是说他不死，乃是说我若要他等到我来的时候，与你何干？
John has a long life with the Lord.
约翰有一个长的人生与主同在。Oh,
and if you look at the history of the church, you just see he went through so many things.
你如果看见教会历史，你看见他经过了好多事。He
saw the glorious beginning of the church in Jerusalem.
他看见那个教会在耶路撒冷荣耀的开始。He
might have seen Ananias and Sapphira die.
也许他看见亚拿尼亚那个死在使徒的脚前。He
might have witnessed, oh, there's this person called Saul, and he's really persecuting the church.
他也许看见，哇，有一个人扫罗何等的逼迫教会。And
then he got saved.
他却得救了。哇！哇！
And then the spread of the churches to the Gentile regions.
Oh,
and then a glorious writings by Paul.
然后呢,
and then in late 60s, Paul gets martyred.
然后60年代, 保罗殉道了。
And then Peter gets martyred.
好，彼得也殉道了。
And then Jerusalem is destroyed by the Roman armies, and there's no more church in Jerusalem.
然后耶路撒冷就被这个罗马的军队所这个毁坏了，就没有耶路撒冷教会了。
And then all of the heretical teachings challenge the church.
许多异端的教训进来挑战教会。
And it's kind of like, you know, going through the stormy sea, and you don't know what's going to happen.
好像看经过一个暴风的海，你不知道会发生什么。
And John is there, remaining.
约翰仍然在那里。
Just remaining.
还在那里。
It's generally agreed that he writes his epistle around 90 something.
一般。
And you know, Peter and Paul were martyred in the late 60s, and then Jerusalem's destroyed in 70. So you might have like 20 years.
知道约保罗跟彼得在60年代末期殉道，然后耶路撒冷70年被毁，所以大概有20年在那里。
What's happening in those 20 years?
那20年发生了什么事？
Remain.
他在那里保持着。
John, remain.
约翰保持着。
I've just been through so many things with the Lord.
我与主经过这么多的事。
I saw the glorious times.
我看见荣耀的时候。
Saw the challenges.
我看见那些的挑战。
I saw what people thought were hopeful situations collapse.
我也看见人所说的好像很有盼望的事情崩塌了。
I saw the gospel spread.
我看见福音广传了。
Brothers come and go.
弟兄们来了又走了。
And I'm just remaining.
我却一直在这里。
I'm really thoroughly beat up by the Lord.
我是这么的被主所制作。
I've drunk the cup.
我接受了那个杯。
And the cup was over many years.
这个杯如此的多年。
And I have been baptized with the baptism.
我受了那该受的浸。
And that was over a long time.Period of time with many experiences.
这么多年，这么多的经历。
And you know what? I have fellowship with the Father and with His Son.
你知道吗？我与父并与他儿子耶稣基督有交通。
And so it was this aged brother.
这是这么一个年迈的弟兄。
Who is no longer acting as a son of thunder.
不再是雷子。
He's not a Christian worker.
不再是一个基督徒工人。
He's one who is in fellowship with the Father and the Son.
他乃是那位与父并与他儿子耶稣基督交通者。
And he sees the whole setting of the churches.
他看见整个教会的情形。
And you know what he realizes? What we need is fellowship.
他说，我们需要交通。
And when he says fellowship, it's not from an empty place.
哦，他说交通的时候并不是空洞的。
He's like, even way back in that day, I was called while I was mending nets.
当我在补网的时候，我就看见这件事。
I learned so many lessons from the Lord.
我从主学到那么多的事。
And I have so many rough edges worn down.
我有这么多的东西这个脱落了。
You know what? I have fellowship with the Father and the Son.
我有与父并与子有交通。
And what is the solution for the churches at this time?
教会的解答在哪里？
I proclaim what I've seen, so you may have fellowship with us.
我将我所看见的、听见的与你们有交通。
Praise the Lord for the power of fellowship.
为着这个有能力的交通，我们赞美神。
So we will continue this afternoon with like how he brought that into the situation in the churches.
下午我们会继续交通，他怎么样带进众教会的交通的情形。Amen.